Desert Race, the toughest, most grueling off-road event on the South African calendar. All the top names are entered, all aware that ahead lies a 1,000-kilometer route through the sandy conditions of the Kalahari. Organized by the four-wheel drive club of South Africa, the route tests both competitor and machine to the absolute limit. Club chairman Peter Wilson and clerk of the course John Saunters have set a tough standard for the desert race. And each year, the desert conditions lay claim to 70% of the field. Run over 3 days, both physical and mechanical preparation must be of the highest standard. And when both are perfect, only luck and absolute effort will ensure success. The route starts in the Northern Cape near Freiburg and slices through an island over Botswana to end at Taylor's Pan on the Botswana border. Here the competitors spend the night before starting the grueling race back to Freiburg. From the start, racing section 2 heads west to Skitter, swings north to the riverbed section and service point at Hennepin, continues north past Heerenvlei, bending back south and then northwest to Taylor's Pan. Racing Section 3 sees the same route but run in reverse. Racing Section 1 consists of a 50-kilometer sprint race against the clock. This to decide the starting order for Racing Section. Then fears and ideas of what lies ahead. We ask some of the top drivers and riders to share their thoughts about the desert race with us.
Expecting speeds in excess of 160 kilometers, and the wheels take a heavy loading, rubbing against the berms all the time, so the car has to be 100% immaculate to finish the race. These type of vehicles, the preparation of the vehicle is most important, and you only find the problems by racing. This is like doing two races, two barber spuns, and it's very important to make sure that the car can get back. If you can get to the overnight stop, you can race back. The desert race, I would say, is possibly more of a challenge than the Roof Africa is, in that your vehicle, your motor, gets put under a lot more pressure than possibly any other race. Speeds are a lot faster. It can be won by single seater, but I think in those days we didn't have the factory teams, which are here today, and it's going to be tough. I'm going to play a little bit of a waiting game and hope that Hannes Philip and Tony Pond are going to have a good go at each other, and hopefully I'll have a chance.
Looking back to past winners, Specials have won 5 times, while the 4x4 trucks have won 7 of the 12 previous events. It's going to be a difficult score to settle.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Hij is de eerste van die beste veldrennen op die kalender in het jaar. Het is een van die langste veldrennen wat daar is. Verleden jaar heb ik die ochtend mijn koers gegeten en ik heb een waterbevering aangepakt. En ik heb begin die 350 kilometer. Het gevoel was dat Piet moest hem hadden aan de oorvat en ook moest hij gelukkig het eigen licentie om te bestellen.
1,000 kilometers, I think maybe a bit a different story as far as I'm concerned when we get to the overnight hold. I mean, I just want to be around the hunt, because on the way back I think it's a time to maybe have a charge, have your a vehicle in good condition at halfway. It will be a good event. It may sort of fizzle out if people have problems by going too quickly. I hope that we don't make that mistake.
We're lucky that there are sponsors to sponsor events like this. It's very expensive and time-consuming to organize something like this. And in our country, I think we are, from hearing from people who have been overseas, we are of the leaders in this off-road motorsport due to the fact that I think weather conditions are ideal. And this all makes for an ideal situation for this finish.
The best of South African bike challenges entered, and any one of 6 or 7 riders could win.
I'm looking forward to the desert race, considering that I won it last year. So, got some addition to winning the game, you know. There's a lot of good competition here this year. Jeremy Davies and Paul Beattie and Willie Allen. Saves his bike the most as the guy's going to get. Uh,
after winning the South African Championship in 85. Very confident and everything. Mark Davies and I spotted out. He was leading. I was second. About 40 kilometers out on the first day. He had a fall, broke his back. I was just slowing up to see what had happened to him when I hit the same rock in the road and I broke my leg. Was out of the race. I didn't race for the whole of 1986. And I'm back again this year. A bit of a twitch in my leg, but I think I'm confident.